Hi, Mr. Professor. Good morning. Could you explain me the principle of transmissibility?
Hi, Mithra. Sure, we will see what the principle of transmissibility is. Where is it applied? And its limitation, etc. A practical example of the meaning of the principle of transmissibility is given when a body is pushed or pulled. If the value of the force with which the body is pulled or pushed is the same, and both forces are applied in the same direction, the resulting movement is exactly the same. Consider the following scenario. You have just depleted the fuel in your car, just before arriving at your uphill home. You must either pull or push to get your car home. By pushing or pulling the car with force P, you can get it home in T time. Both the pushing and pulling will produce the same result or consequence if the force applied in the two cases has the same line of action. To put it another way, pushing or pulling a car forward with the same force P, which has the same line of action in both cases, and in the same direction produces the same consequences. Then, what is principle of transmissibility of forces? Or, law of transmissibility of forces? It states that, the external effect of a force on a rigid body, is the same for all points of application along its line of action. That is, it is independent of the point of application. Take a look at the system in the diagram. The system is pushed or pulled forward by applying force, P, on the system. It's also important to note that in both cases of pulling and pushing, the line of action of force, P, is the same as shown in the diagram. If the system is moving on a frictionless surface, the acceleration of the system in both the cases is equal to applied force, P, over mass, M. And it is independent of the point of application. We know from Newton's second law, the net force applied to a body of mass M produces a proportional acceleration. Look here. In the first situation, a rigid body with mass M is pushed by a force P, while in the second situation, the same rigid body is pulled by the same force P, in the same direction and line of action. Both cases have the same acceleration, which is equal to force P over mass M. We may now observe a few examples of the transmissibility principle. Here's a ball for you. It is being acted upon by three forces, P1, P2, and P3. In the first scenario, all three forces appear to be approaching the ball from distinct directions, whereas in the second situation, the forces appear to be pulling the ball away in their respective directions. Importantly, the lines of action of the forces are the same in both cases. Due to the principle of transmissibility, you'll observe that these forces have the same consequences in both cases. As a result, these systems are equivalent to each other. In these systems also, the pull or push by force, P, with same line of action, produces the same effect on the rigid body. Here is an L-shaped rigid body subjected to a force P. Figure depicts various ways of applying the same force P in the same line of action, which results in the same effect on the body. Due to the principle of transmissibility of forces, all these systems we have seen so far are equivalent to each other. The principle of transmissibility states that the point of application of a force can be moved anywhere along its line of action without changing the external reaction forces on a rigid body.
What are the limitations?
The principle of transmissibility can only be used for analyzing the external forces on the rigid bodies, not for the forces on deformable bodies. Mithra, I hope now you understood the principle of transmissibility for analyzing the system of external forces.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Professor.